gentlemen, on behalf of Dean and Lisa, I'd like to welcome you all here today to the occasion of our wedding. My name is Aoife and I'll be today's celebrant. All of you shared, supported and contributed to their lives in the past, and by witnessing their marriage here today, Dean and Lisa ask that you share in their future also. This ceremony today is about love. Love isn't just a word, it's an action. Love isn't something you say, it's something you do. Love is genuine, open, compassionate and kind. Love doesn't know space nor time nor look through jealous eyes. It means the world to them both that you're all here today to witness their marriage. So I invite you now to leave behind the everyday worries and concerns of everyday life and join us in this celebration of love. So let me take you back quite a number of years ago. Lisa and Dean first started out as childhood sweethearts back in first year in school. Even if Dean did slagger, he still bought her Winnie the Pooh stickers. But the timing just wasn't right for both of them, and they had some growing and learning to do, and life took them on different journeys. That was until one night in the Sally Garden pub, where their paths crossed once more and fate intervened, also known as Katie, and their romance was rekindled. Lisa says she pretty much moved in 2 days later. Taylor Lee made a dramatic arrival into the world in 2019. Lisa and Dean had to grow up fast. Trips up and down to Temple Street over the next couple of months was a challenge for them, but one they happily accepted and took in their stride. They told me that this just made them stronger as a couple, like they could face anything together. It was a week after Taylor Lee's arrival that Dean knew that Lisa was the one he wanted to marry and asked her to marry him. They still had a lot more adventures to come before actually getting married and getting to today, including welcoming Ivy in 2015 and little Avery in 2017. After 10 years together, Dean felt it was only right to refresh the proposal and the ring. So for their 10th anniversary, in front of the kids and Lisa's parents, he got down on one knee and once again asked Lisa to marry him. As an adult this time, he told me. And that is what has us all here today. In preparation for today's ceremony, Lisa and Dean were asked one question about one another, the answers they kept private and secret from each other until today. When I asked Lisa what Dean meant to her, she replied, "He means the absolute world to me. I can't put into words to describe how much he means to me and my life. All I know is from today, the 2nd of March, he's mine forever." And when I asked Dean what Lisa means to him, he replied, "Lisa means the world to me. She's a great mother to our three girls and has a unique personality. She's intelligent, caring, and her beautiful eyes and smile are just a bonus. She cares about us and will always support us. She is definitely the girl I want to marry and spend the rest of my life with." I think it's clear, ladies and gentlemen, that Lisa and Dean are soulmates who are meant to find each other and create this life together with the three beautiful girls. Lisa and Dean, today you're promising in front of all these people that you love that you want to be with each other and own each other for the rest of your lives, and that you will do everything within your power to honour the promises you're about to make here today. I'd like to draw your attention to the table here to my left. It is always difficult to deal with the loss of loved ones who have passed away, but remember they are always with us. Dean and Lisa would like to remember all the family and friends of all here present. We are reminded of the impact that these people have had in our lives, helping to mould us into the individuals we have become. We acknowledge their influence and feel confident that they too share in this special day. Through the lighting of this candle, we are reminded that their love for us is eternal, and true love never fades despite the passing of time.
Once upon a time, a boy met a girl. She gave him her hand and he held it tight. Together they set off down the unknown path in front of them. Sometimes they walked slowly, sometimes at a quicker pace. Sometimes they ran so fast the sun felt like flying. Whenever he lost his footing, she steadied him, and whenever she tripped, he helped her back up. Whenever she grew weary, he'd carry her. Sometimes they didn't know which direction to go, but though they would occasionally lose their way, they never lost each other. They wandered contently and lived happily forever and always side by side.
So what is marriage? A joyful marriage is never being too old to hold hands. It's remembering to say I love you. It is at no time taking the other for granted. Let your courtship not end with the honeymoon, but continue throughout the years. Your marriage will be a great journey of joy, surprises and miracles. But remember, above all, your love for each other will prevail. No ceremony can create a marriage. What this ceremony can do is witness and affirm the choices you've made today to become husband and wife. Marriage is not an event, but an inner spiritual journey. It's a path towards mutual enrichment, a give and take between two people, a mingling of two endowments, which diminishes neither, but enhances both. Your marriage will provide you with the comfort and the safety of an embrace from one who will not judge you by your mistakes, but will love you in spite of them. You will always have the security of having a partner who believes in you and supports you without condition. Be who you are, say what you feel, because those who mind don't matter, and those who matter don't mind. Dean and Lisa, delighting at this unity candle, you are symbolising your lives as individuals and as a family. This candle before you is a candle of commitment, because it takes two people working together to keep it aflame. This candle is also a candle of unity, because both must come together, giving a spark of yourselves to create a new life. Your mothers gave you light by bringing you into this world. It's only fitting and right that they give you love and support as you continue this next journey as husband and wife. Cindy, can you please pick up your taper and light it? And together with Dean, light his candle and let it be a symbol of the light shining inside himself, remembering how special he is. And together with Lisa, light her candle and let her be a symbol of the light shining inside her, remembering how special she is. Lisa and Dean, in the lighting of this unity candle, you've symbolised your lives as individuals and as a couple. The two outer candles represent your lives up to this moment. They are both two distinct lights, each bright and shining on their own. Can we please get a round of applause for the mummies and light these?
Not perfect. You aren't either, and the two of you will never be perfect. But if he can make you laugh at least once, cause you to do twice, and if he admits to being human and making mistakes, hold on to him and give him the most you can. He isn't going to quote poetry. He's not thinking about you every moment, but he will give you a part of him that he knows you could break. Don't hurt him. Don't change him. Don't expect for more than he can give. Don't analyze. Smile when he makes you happy. Yell when he makes you mad. And miss him when he's not there. Love hard when there is love to be had. Perfect guys don't exist, but there's always one guy that is perfect for you.
This particular ceremony outdates both state and religious marriage. Can I please ask Jack, Rick, Mark, Tommy and Paul to come up and join us please at the top. These are the hands of your best friend, all of love for you, and are holding yours on your wedding day, as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow and forever. Rick, you're next. These are the hands that will work alongside yours together as you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. Regina? These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. Tommy?
Regina.
These are the hands that will help hold your family as one. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just one touch. Now as we stand there, really let these feelings register in your heart and in your mind. We all know that your visions for the future are not identical, but will always be complementary. John Lennon once said, "A dream you dream alone is but a dream. A dream you dream together, that is reality." And your new reality starts here today. Can we please get a round of applause for our invitation? Look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you've been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, companion,
dancing partner, even teacher. You've learned so much for each other these past 10 years. Shortly, you shall say a few words that will take you over the threshold of life, and things between you will never be quite the same again. For after today, you will say to the world that this is my husband and this is my wife. Do you, Dean, hereby state that you've read and understood the list of legal impediments to marriage, and you do solemnly declare that you believe that there is no impediment of kindred or affinity or of lawful hindrance to propose marriage with Lisa?
I know.
Come on. You've very little to say here. Do you, Lisa, hereby state that you've read and understood the civil impediments to marriage, and you do solemnly declare that you believe that there is no impediment of kindred or affinity or of your lawful hindrance to propose marriage with Dean?
I do.
It is now that I, Aoife Hurley, in accordance with the rights of the Spiritualist Union of Ireland, do solemnise this, your marriage, in accordance with the laws of the country. Before you, Dean and Lisa, are joined together in my presence and the presence of you witnesses. I am bound, as you know, to remind you publicly of the solemn, the serious and the binding nature of the relationship in which you are about to enter. Marriage, as most of us understand it, is a voluntary and a full commitment of two people to one another. It is made with the deepest sense to the exclusion of all others, and is entered into with the desire, the hope, and the firm intention it will last a lifetime. Dean, do you take Lisa in marriage to be your wedded wife, to share your life as your friend, your companion, to grow together in spirit and truth, forsaking all others?
I do.
And do you, Lisa, take Dean in marriage to be your wedded husband, to share your life as your friend, your companion, to grow together in spirit and truth, forsaking all others?
I do.
Wedding bands are the perfect circle, having no beginning and no end. But we all know that these rings do have a beginning. Rock is dug up from the earth. Metal is liquefied in a furnace. Hot metal is poured into a mould, cooled, and then painstakingly polished. Something beautiful is made from raw materials. Love is like that. It has to be worked at. It's a process of making something beautiful where there was once nothing at all. Are you now ready to give and accept these symbolisms of love?
We are.
As I stand here before you, Lisa, looking into your eyes, I see all of the things I fell in love with. As I stand here before you, my heart beating so strongly, I find myself so lost for the right words to say. With this ring in my hand, it makes me remember every laugh we ever shared, every hard time we made it through together, and every beautiful moment there is to come. I give you this ring, my heart, my soul. I give you the everything I am today. I promise to love you, to be the best husband and dad I can be to our three beautiful daughters, to protect you, to be yours forever, and to cherish every moment with you. With this ring, let it be known, I choose you. I promise to be with you till death does us apart.
When I look back on everything we have been through, above all, I have loved watching you, the man you have become. A loving partner, a truly great father to our daughters. Watching you with them is the best feeling in the world. I love how you know what to say when the stress gets too much. You make the heavy load seem a lot lighter. So today I vow never to be afraid to work on our relationship. I vow to be your wife, best friend, and best mother to our daughters. I love you always and forever. It's a bit sweaty down.
It's okay, I've got it on. It's okay. It's on.
Before I pronounce you husband and wife, I have just one more thing I want you to do. Your wedding day is one that seems to fly by. It's a day filled with emotion, friends, rings and dances. Many people remember how fleeting their own wedding day was. So I want you now to take a few seconds to look into each other's eyes. Think about the happiness you are feeling in this moment, in this place, at this time.
Dean and Lisa have declared before us all that they will live together in marriage. They symbolise this by making promises to each other, exchanging rings, joining hands. So therefore, on your behalf, and on the behalf of the community in the sight of spirit, I now declare them to be husband and wife. Dean, you may kiss. Which will always be an outward demonstration of the vows and the love and respect, and a public showing of your commitment to each other. You now have what remains, the most honourable title that may exist between a man and a woman, the title of husband and wife. For your first gift as husband and wife, the gift of a single rose. In the past, the rose is considered a symbol of love, and a single rose always meant one thing. It meant the words, I love you. So it is appropriate that your first gift as husband and wife would be a gift of a single rose. Please now exchange your first gift as husband and wife. In some ways, you've not done anything at all. Just a moment ago, you were holding one small rose, and now you're still holding one small rose. In some ways, a marriage ceremony is like this. In some ways, tomorrow is going to seem no different than yesterday. But in fact, today, just now, you've both given and received one of the most valuable and precious gifts of life. One I hope you will always remember. The gift of true and abiding love within devotion of marriage. Lisa and Dean, I would ask that wherever you make your home in the future, both pick one very special location for these roses, so that on each anniversary of what is truly this wonderful occasion, you both may take one rose to that spot as a recommitment to this marriage. A recommitment to this marriage based upon love. In every marriage, there will be times that it is difficult to find the right words. It is easiest to hurt the ones we love the most. It is easiest to be hurt by the ones we love the most. It might be difficult sometimes to find the words, I'm sorry, or I forgive you, I need you, or I'm hurting. If this should happen, you simply cannot find these words, leave a rose at that spot which you both have now selected. For that rose then says, what matters most of all, and should overpower all things else, and all other words. This rose says, I still love you. The other should accept this rose for the words that cannot be found. And remember the love and hope that you share here today. Lisa and Dean, if there's anything you remember from this marriage ceremony, it is that it was one of love that brought you here today. And it is one of love that will make you and take you on this glorious reunion. And it is love in which a marriage shall endure. You will now hear the third reading from Jenna. Would you please come and join us?
You're surrounded by your loved ones and all are wishing you well. You create a brand new chapter in the story that you hope to tell. We talk about the memories you have yet to make together and the moments you've already shared to be carried with you forever. But take the time to live today as your marriage begins. Look around and soak it up, the moment we are in. For this is where the magic starts, when you both say your vows. You pledge to spend your life as one because of the love you feel now. So yes, here's to a future that is bright, warm and clear. But more than that, here's to right now and what it means to be here.
Thank you very much. Symbolize your lives separately. In the lighting of this center candle, this represents your two lives now being joined together as one. Now, Dean and Lisa, I'd like you to remember when it was in your relationship that you first realized that you were truly in love and wanted to spend the rest of your lives together. Dean, please take your paper and take a flame from Lisa's candle, symbol of the inner light inside of Lisa, lit by eternal light and dedication to repeat it again and again wherever necessary. And Lisa, can you please take a flame from Dean's candle, a symbol of the inner light inside of Dean, lit by eternal light, with dedication to rekindle it again and again wherever necessary. With these candles, we can see how to achieve a beautiful relationship. In your relationship, you will try and bring these lights, symbols of yourselves, closer and closer together. Sand of various colours symbolise your individual spirits and that of your children and families. Each container is unique, representing who you are and what you bring to this union. As you do so, embody the grains with all your hopes and dreams for the future. Bring to mind the strength of the promises and the honesty and the integrity in which you're about to make them. And all the particles of your personalities that make you unique and wonderful in each other's eyes. Yeah, sorry. Yeah. Within a marriage, each person is both their own and each other's. Two individuals choosing to become one and create new life with endless possibilities and dreams which are theirs together. Can you now see, Taylor Lee, do you see where you are? Yep, and Avery and Ivy?
Yeah. Do you want to help, Ryan?
Yep. These containers of sand are here to represent you guys and your importance in your parents' hearts. There we go. Like the colours of the rainbow, you're all different and special, valuable and precious. Therefore, it is only fitting and right to be shown as an important part in this marriage. After all, marriage is really about family. Well done, thank you very much. And Dean and Lisa, can you please finish pouring the rest of your sand in? There is nothing more important nor sacred than the bond you share as husband and wife and family. Taylor Lee, Ivy and Avery, do you see where you all are? You are at the centre of your parents' hearts, now and forever. Just as these individual grains of sand can never be separated, our prayer for you is that your lives together will be longer than the time it will take to separate these individual grains of sand. You are united today not only in marriage, but as a family. But please get a round of applause for the three girls. Dean and Lisa, may your home be a place for all of happiness for all who enter it. A place where the old and the young are renewed in each other's company. A place for growing, a place for sharing, a place for love. May those who are here to see you constantly enriched by the beauty and the bounty of your love for one another. May your work be a joy in this world as it serves the world, and may your days be good and long upon this earth. Ladies and gentlemen, may you all please be of standing for the greatest pleasure presented to you. To you, Mr. and Mrs. Kerr.
When I'm falling, losing myself, but in there you call it.
For those of you that don't know me, my name is Larry. I'm Dean's older brother, unfortunately. May I start off by saying, you all look smashing today, and I'd like to thank you, each and every one of you, for joining us here on this special day. You are all very welcome.
Stand up. Larry wrote this, so I don't think I have to really say anything about it.
Start off there, huh?
Oh. I would also like to thank Dean for being a being on time today. Seeing as he was up drinking all last night and sang us all to sleep. I couldn't believe my eyes, he was actually here before the bride. We are working together now for the past 12 years. That's Lawrence. I'm reading his jokes. This is all wrong. I couldn't believe my eyes. We were actually here before the bride. We were working together for the past 12 years. And I honestly say he was never once on time. And never seemed to rush. That's our Dean, yeah? Takes it easy, loves himself, looks himself in the mirror. Most mornings, I would ring him when I was outside. All I would get is, oh shite, sorry brother, me alarm never went off.
Right.
Same old Lino, isn't it, every time.
Me phone is
fucked. Oh sorry Lawrence, me phone is fucked, should I make it one? I have this one the last 12 years.
Dino says, 12 years later, same phone, same excuse. Well, you know that one yourself, don't you, bud? Other mornings, he'd answer, yeah, getting up now, brother. So I'd say, I'd be outside waiting in the van. He would stroll down the stairs, out to the kitchen, boil the kettle, eat his cereal slowly, make his lunch, then make a cup of tea. Then he'd make 2 slices of fucking toast. He'd stroll back up the fucking stairs to check his hair. In the mirror, of course. And then he'd stroll out to the van. And he'd say, good morning, brother. Jesus, you're fucking early this morning. This is at 9:15. But who would blame Dean today? I'm sure every man in this room wouldn't want to keep a bride as beautiful as Lisa.
We wouldn't want to leave a bride as beautiful as Lisa waiting, I'm sure. You all would agree Lisa looks stunning today. Oh, Lisa, boy! On you go, thing. Along with the bridesmaids. Oh, yeah, they're looking well. Especially Cindy down there, she's looking well in the new dress. Yeah. And of course the 2 mammies. I have known Lisa for the past 10 years or more, and I just want to say fair play to her for putting up with Dean. Dean shit actually was on this, so I might as well read it out. Oh, Dean shite this long. I'm sure sometimes she feels like she has 4 kids instead of 3. I have to say, this is off my heart now. Lisa, you're an absolutely brilliant mother. I always said it. You've 3 beautiful daughters.
And
they're absolutely beautiful. And you're a super mom. You're absolutely super. Yeah. Takes a lot to do that. Yeah. Takes a lot. This is off the chart now, but I've only 1 baby, but Owen is a super mother as well, and she's brilliant. She's absolutely brilliant. Yeah, I didn't realise how hard it were until the game.
It's not about you now.
Yeah, well, I'll have to get that in there anyway. Lads, babies are serious, you know, we're protective.
You're best, sure, I never.
So now I would like to pass you over to father of the bride, Jack. Oh, Jez. Yes, Jack, in for now. Also, there's a lot of people travelled here from Australia.
Canada
and England tonight.
Jamaica.
I think there's about 3 Jamaican people. Don't even start rousing tonight because they're carrying knives. A lot of people travelled here tonight for this. Fair dues to them. It means a lot to Dean. And you're brilliant. Everyone is brilliant here tonight. Even the people that, you know, there's a lot of us local, we're cousins, we're friends, and
inbreds,
everything. Super stuff. Fucking brilliant. Bring it on. Have a good time tonight and enjoy yourselves. Here's Jack Kelly, boy. Man of the night.
How am I going to follow that? I I want to thank you all for coming to Lisa and Dean's very special day. And we hope you all have a lovely day. I'd like to welcome Dean officially into the family after 10 years. But he's been part of the family from day one anyway. Just a short story about Dean. It's not much, but... My boss Dennis is out there somewhere. Are you there? So anytime Dennis gets busy, he says to me, Jack, will you get somebody to give you a hand for a few days? So the first one I phone is Dean. It's not because he's a great worker or anything, because I know there's some part of the day I'm going to get a great laugh. And this particular, it didn't even go today, it was this morning. We were in Dennis's house, walking around the garden anyway. And so Dennis, he has an electric fence around it for the dog. So Dean says to me, Jack, he says, is that fence working? Yes, I don't know, Dean. I said, I think it is. I'm not sure. So we're walking around anyway, and I got his back turned for a couple of minutes, and so I sneak into the garage, and I turn on the fence anyway. So we're walking around anyway, and he says, here, Jack, he says, what's that noise? I say, what noise? So everybody knows the noise of electric fence, don't they? Dean doesn't. So the minute I said it, he grabs the fence. So he's looking at me. His mouth is open. His eyes are ready to pop out of his head. He wants to call me every name under the sun. And probably beat the crap out of me as well, I don't know. But all I could do was just lie on that floor and laugh. All day. But listen, apart from all that, this is why anytime Dennis phones me, he's the man I'll phone, because I've just great time for the chap. Great time for him. So that's... All right, Dean. All right, brother. Lisa. I've been waiting on this moment for 29 years now. And the day has arrived where I have to hand you over, my princess, to Dean. But it's great to know she's marrying one of the best men I know, who loves her just as much as I do. So if I had to choose anyone for you, Lisa, well, it would be Dean. I would also like to say I am so proud to have Dean as my son-in-law, and he's a great father to my three grandkids. So everybody knows out there, all teenage girls, to have, to love girly bands, don't they? But Lisa's was the Nolan sisters. Now, look, no money kidding. It was Destiny's Child. So we had two tickets anyway to go up to the Pint Depot, as it was called at the time. So we go up, we're in the queue, whatever, the whole lot. So we get inside the door, and all the stewards are there anyway doing their job. So this steward comes over to us, and we give him the ticket. He looks at it, right, he said, come on, you're in the standing area. So we go up anyway, up to the standing area, we're there, and he says, are you happy there? Are you happy where you are? And he said, thanks very much, yeah. So I turned around to Lisa and I said to her, what did I say, Lisa? Huh? Yeah, I said to her, Lisa, I said, wasn't that nice of the steward? Yeah, she said it was. Dad, do you know him? I said, no, I don't know. So why do you ask me that? Well, she, how did you know his name is Steward? She said to me. I said, Lisa, he's a steward, his name is not steward. Right? So, at the end of the evening anyway, the concert was over, the whole lot. So we were on the standing area, so we were last getting out of the hall. So we're standing there, just shuffling along. So Lisa gets one of her brainwaves anyway. She said, "Dad, come on, we go over there and join that queue over there." She's not many in that queue over there, she says. No, I said, "Right, okay, Lisa, okay." So we go over anyway, and we're in the queue, walking along. So next we realise we're walking on the red carpet. So we're walking along, so we're looking around the place. So next, Bonner was walking beside us, The Edge was walking beside us, Roland Keaton was walking beside us, Ian Dempsey was walking beside us. So the two of us are looking at one another, we start laughing at one another. I said, "Lisa, what are you at to doing?" So we decided, "We keep walking, see how far we get anyway." So we get down as far as the doors anyway, right? And the doors open in front of us. Beyonce's on the far side of the doors. So the next two bouncers are standing in front of us, you know, and he's looking at us. "Where the hell do you think you two are going, you know?" So that was it. Back over to the other queue. Queuing again, twice as long to get out of the place. So, everybody has memories. Lovely memories. Everybody out there has lovely memories about everything. And these, my memories are like these, you know, I'll never forget these memories of my beautiful daughter, you know. So I'm going to finish up now and just say I want to toast to Lisa and Dean. And I hope to have a beautiful life together.
Hi everyone. I welcome you all here today to celebrate the special occasion of Lisa and Dean's wedding. It's been a wonderful day so far, but it's up to us to make it even better. I'd like to thank everyone who has been involved in the planning, the hotel management and staff, and especially Lisa and Dean, to make this all happen. I compliment the bride and groom on how well they look. Also the bridesmaids and groomsmen who have done a wonderful job today. I also thank Lisa's parents for the wonderful daughter they raised. And just to remember grandparents who have passed away and can't be here, but I know their thoughts are with them. I welcome Lisa into the Byrne family and wish them both happiness and health for the future ahead. So raise your glasses and toast a happy couple, yeah. Mr. and Mrs. Byrne.
Look, me and Dean were no angels. Now, this is me you're looking at. This is Lawrence you're looking at here when I'm saying this, right? Right. Look, me and Dean were no angels growing up, as you know. You can all imagine we caused a lot of mischief. I would love to imagine what mischief Dean caused. The only thing is, I was better at not getting caught. That's Lawrence. Little old snake there in the corner. And you know what? He's that much of a snake, he's still not even talking tonight. Little old rat. Right. So, this is his words now. This is the words of a rat. For example, me and Dean always used to think we were Indians. And for some reason, Dean was amazed with matches. Oh, yes, he loved the matches because he lit Mammy's fucking...
Wait, no, don't!
No, he lit her whole thing up in fire. The whole thing. He lit our sitting room up in fire, Dean did, when he was a young lad. Oh, he did, yeah, he lit it up. Had to get that in there. So one day, Dean rubbed Mammy's matches and Larry brought Dean into the brother's school. That's just right behind us. The brother's school. Now it's lucky that shut down, or this could have come in a court case. So Dean brought the matches to the brother's school behind our house where he had our camp. Larry and Dean had a little old camp, did they? Oh, Jess, I never knew about that. So Dean started off his fire. Oh, Jess, he loved the old fires, are Dean, yeah? Oh, yeah, Dean started up a fire and started dancing, making weird noises. What sort of noises did you make, Dean?
There it is, on the fucking right now. What noises did you make?
Dean started making little noises, little languages. Okay, yeah. He started.
What, like what?
Dean started making little noises and start dancing and making weird noises like an Indian. And for anyone that knows their brother's school, you know they're surrounded by evergreen trees. Yeah, there's trees all over the place. That's where Dean probably lit the fucking matches, didn't he? And within the space of an hour, there was fuck all evergreens. So, and that's to be straight out about it. Because our little Dean lit the fucking evergreens up on fire, didn't he, yeah? Oh, he did, yeah. He lit them all up. Yeah, and there was sirens going off everywhere. Now, that's the end of that one anyway. So, I'd love to see what's coming apart too. Oh, Mammy's going to go mad with you tonight, babe. We were blaming someone else for that. So we ran home. That's Lawrence and Dean now, they ran home. And we only had to look us. She knew it was us. Mammy knew it was you. She just...
No,
Mammy seen flames and she knew it was the two boys. That wouldn't surprise me anyway. So the two boys ran upstairs and hid under the bed for probably a week. And said, don't ever tell your father, because daddy... straight out, daddy's a mad bastard. There's no ifs or buts about it. Daddy's fucking mad. But he's chilled out with it in the last few years anyway. if daddy finds out about it, hell will fucking kill ye. Now that was the old daddy, but he's changed now. Daddy's gone.
That's our new daddy.
So now that you know
daddy never
who knew. Burnt the fucking brother school. But he never found out. Yeah? He never found out. And that's why Dean and Lawrence are still alive today. Dean Byrne is marrying the best looking woman in Borleach! He's a Kelly boy! Yeah, we were never born into money. The Byrnes weren't born into money, but Lawrence made a few pounds now. He's keeping that on the QT, the tax man gets him. He's doing well at the old tile and all. I never made a penny anyway, so taxman's not. If he's here tonight, don't bother coming after me. Oh, daddy and mammy worked hard. And we never they did. Mammy and daddy did work hard. Very hard workers. There were six of us in the family. We had a tough life.
With daddy.
Oh, Jesse was a cunt. But yeah, you're brilliant now. You're good now.
And
we never wanted to threaten. You were great parents. And the last thing I have to say is, they've done their best. Listen, I'd like to thank everyone for coming here tonight. You're absolutely brilliant. I hope you have a great fucking night. And so here's another page now I have to read. I think they're writing the pages according as I'm speaking. Who's that now?
We.
Lawrence, this is Lawrence. Lawrence used to love going hunting.
Me?
Years ago, obviously, because Lawrence used to love going hunting, him and Dean.
We.
Darren, Damien and Daddy, when we were young. And Dean's 10th birthday, Daddy asked Dean what he would like for Dean's...
Birthday.
And Dean, and his birthday is a big word. don't creep me on the big words now here tonight.
So Dean's eyes.
Daddy asked Dean, what would he like? Dean's eyes lit up and he said, ah, sure, yeah, typical Dean, yeah. Oh yeah, I'd like a fucking shotgun now, wouldn't I? Huh? I don't live up the north, but I'd like a shotgun. So Dean went to the shotgun. And sure, Daddy and Mammy had an old discussion. And sure, Daddy robbed Mammy's money and bought Dean a shotgun, didn't he? Oh yeah, he bought him an old 410. 410 is kind of a small gun, but Dean went around like he was a big man with it. For the first week, he thought he was Rambo. I was showing it everything. He was showing little robins and all them old yorks, and there was no need to be shooting at them at all. But sure, Dean, that was Dean anyway. Dean had a shotgun. And he was going to shoot whatever he wanted. Little Rambo. So one morning, Danny woke us and said, "Lads, we're going for a shot. Today we're going to be men." So we were delighted. And we went with our guns and we went out in the fields and we went for our first wounded victim.
The first shot
Lauren Scott was a crow. But he wounded him. That's bad.
Couldn't kill him.
Yeah, but there'll be a lot of vegetarians here tonight too. No. Like, life has changed since we used to be doing shooting. You know, everything's changed since Facebook. But anyway, so he wounded him anyway. So if you don't like wounding, fuck out. So Lawrence wounded him anyway. Me and Dean after him.
Me and Dean ran after him.
Me, Lawrence and Dean ran after the crow.
Crow.
Yeah. And one side of, Lawrence ran one side of the ditch and Dean ran the other side of the ditch. Then Lawrence ran the other side of the ditch. I don't know how many ditches in this fucking York. But Lawrence knows he heard his brother. That could have been Darren.
No, Dean said.
And have you seen him?
Well, Dean said.
What happened? What happened to all the animal lovers?
Come here, I'll tell you what fucking...
Bang!
Dean says to me, he says, "Larry, I see the bastard." He says, "I'm going to kill him." Bang. My life fucking flashed before my eyes. He missed the crow, straight out through the ditch. He missed me by fucking inches. And to this day, I always say, it wasn't the fucking crow Dean was trying to shoot. It was fucking me. Look, I could keep you here all night, folks, telling stories about me and Dean growing up. Some you won't believe. Some I still can't fucking believe.
I think Lawrence is crying now, guys. Anyway, all us birds want to say is we hope everyone fucking enjoys themselves tonight and have a fucking party! Woo! Enjoy yourselves, have a drink, and there's a lot of people here who don't know each other tonight. Everyone mingle in, have a chat, do the crack and live fucking life forever, because we're not here for a long time. We're here for a good time! Dean is a great father to three beautiful nieces. He's a hard worker, he's loyal, kind, grateful, and he's always around, most of the time anyway. And all he is known is my best friend. And I can't tell you how proud I am today to see the man that have become and married the love of his life, Dean Byrne.
Aye.
Fair juicy, Dean. You've just met her, a beautiful friend.
Now it's my turn. Now, folks,
That's all the speeches over with. I'm taking the mic. Thanks everybody for coming. Lisa and Dean looks absolutely stunning. Dean has a few words to say now. Do you want a few words to say, Dean? Thank you all for coming and spending this special day with Lisa and Dean. And I hope you all have a marvellous time and we'll have great memories.
Go on, hang out.
I had to take it off. I'm sorry, folks.
I'll try not be as long as these. Fucking hell, I couldn't get you off the mic. I just want to thank all my family and friends for coming to celebrate our special day with us. Without you, we couldn't make this happen. I also want to thank you for your lovely gifts, presents, cards, and all your kind regards and best wishes. So, so us to that. Now, to my beautiful wife, you just look incredible today. I met Lisa in first year. She was the girl that all the boys couldn't get. Me be me, I said, I'll get her. It took me a while. Lisa was always the girl with new runners. So I used to go home to my mother and tell her, I need new runners. Poor Ma, she was broke every week. Little did I know it would take more than new runners to impress Lisa. I found out she liked Winnie the Pooh stickers. I know, she was 13 at the time. So I was lucky. My sister Gina worked in Lisa's education at the time. I went over on my lunch break one day, went to Gina and asked if they had Winnie the Pooh stickers. She said she'd have them, brought them home for me. So I couldn't wait. Next day I went back to school with these stickers, into home economics class, took out these stickers and told Lisa they were for her. She took them, but never said anything. Next day, went back into school. I got passed a piece of paper from her friend. It said, she will meet you after school up in St. Bridget's for the shift. So that's how I got to know Lisa. Sure, me being me, I left school after third year. I didn't see Lisa for a few years. After that, until one night, I went out with my best man, Larry. I went to Sally Gardens, and there she was, 11 years later. Now look where I am, married now, with three beautiful daughters, Taylor Lee, Ivy, and Avery, and a beautiful wife. So Lisa. So Lisa, I just want you to know that I love you so much. You mean the world to me and the kids. Now I can finally say you're one of us now, a burn. I love you, babe, forever. Oh. To the bridesmaids, Samantha, Michelle and Tanya, you look gorgeous. Thanks for all your help over the last few days, for keeping Lisa relaxed and for giving Lisa a good weekend away for her hen. She deserved it. And most of all, getting her to the island time for me. Thanks again. Now, the lads, Darren, Damien and Lawrence, you're not just friends, you're best friends, you're my brothers. I know you're there for me whenever I need you. Darren, thanks for playing the bagpipes, you were brilliant. Larry, my best man. That's why he is there. I remember the first day I went off to first class, Larry brought me. What way? Out to the ditch. He taught me how to climb a tree and showed me how to get down by pushing me over it. Didn't you, Larry?
Picture over.
And Daddy caught us and you know what happened. Thanks, brothers. I love you. My mother-in-law and father-in-law, just want to say thank you for welcoming me into your home. And not you, Jack. You wouldn't talk to me for a month. But now look at us, you say we're like brothers. Thanks again for your beautiful daughter, now my beautiful wife. And just a present there and that for you. So, on behalf of myself and Lisa, and the kids. So. Can I give it to them?
Me?
Now, my mammy, what can I say? I had you broke by me runners. Now you know what it was for, to impress Lisa, my wife. You have always been there for me, Lisa, and the kids. I love you, Mar. You're the best. You always look beautiful. You also look beautiful today. It's nice to see you all your pyjamas for once. And just a present for flowers for Mammy, is it? No, my dad. All I can say is you made me the man I am today. I looked up to you growing up and I took in everything you taught me. And because of that, you made me as good as a father as you were to me. I love you both. And finally, I would like to thank the staff and management here at the Clanard Court for their excellent service. They were great to work with. So that's all I have to say now. I hope you all enjoy your evening and you all get up to dance and don't be sitting down for the night.
Lazy bastard.
For me and my stunning wife and my three beautiful daughters, have a great night and enjoy. Toast to that. I said toast to that. That's it.
O'clock rock, 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock rock, 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock rock. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. But it's glad right, so join me home. We'll have some fun when the clock strikes one. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. We're gonna rock, rock, rock till broad daylight. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. When the clock strikes 2, 3, and 4. 12, we'll cool off and start around.